know, Robbie, first of all, what is the membership economy? I mean, we've heard about it from American Express. They're probably the most well-known for the membership play.
So it's a massive transformational trend that I've seen with virtually every industry, from software to hospitality to financial services. And it's all about a move from ownership to access, from anonymous transactions to known relationships, and from one-way communication where you're just pushing messages at your customer to an open conversation, not just between you and the consumer, but also among the customers themselves under your umbrella.
So this sounds like this is a fundamental strategy shift. I mean, really a very different way of thinking about how you engage with customers in every aspect of your business.
Yeah, absolutely. It's about putting the customer at the center of everything you do, instead of the product or the processes or even the technology.
Tell us about some of the core elements that are enabling this transformation to happen around membership.
Yeah, well, so membership is not new, right? I mean, we've had membership since the 12th century, trade guilds and religious groups. But what's happened recently, two big things. One of them is that technology has extended the infrastructure that enables trusting relationships. So we've always wanted to have these long-term relationships with the companies that serve us, but now it's possible to do that not just with companies that we know personally, like the shop around the corner, but actually with organizations where we've never met anybody. And these are through technologies like always-on devices, mobility, artificial intelligence that gives us a personalized experience, the ability to connect networks. All of that is enabling new ways of relating. The other thing is the influx of capital, financial capital, that is giving entrepreneurs a longer runway to build relationships with their customers before they actually have to generate revenue.
So the fact that we are always connected and we have so many different ways to connect is enabling these organizations to think differently about how to be a part of those connections.
Yeah, it's like a new palette of colors that you can use when you're painting your business model.
I love that. Can you tell us, can you give us some examples about some companies that have taken advantage of this new palette?
Yeah, well, there's two groups. There's what I think of as the digital natives, the Amazons, LinkedIn, Netflix, who started their businesses thinking about the forever transaction, thinking about this long-term member-oriented approach. And then there are companies that have transformed to membership models, companies like Intuit and Adobe, who have moved from these anonymous box transactions to a real ongoing relationship, subscription model, community with the people they serve.
So Robbie, you know that at Singularity University, we spend a lot of time talking about impact. Does the membership economy work in the social sector? You know, are there other examples that you've seen of organizations that are not necessarily in the corporate world that are using this strategy?
Yeah, well, you guys talk a lot about grand challenges. And one organization that I work with, the American Nurses Association, has a grand challenge going on right now where they're focused on helping the 3.5 million nurses in the US get healthy. Because nurses are on the five major elements of health, which is like, you know, stress, sleep, weight, smoking, and I think drugs maybe. I think those are the five. They perform less well than the American population at large in 4 out of 5. So they're using online community, they're using their subscription model, they're using their live events, all to support this initiative, this grand challenge around making nurses as healthy as possible this year.
I think that all leaders are going to need to really take a hard look at their business model. What suggestions would you have for leaders that want to really understand how to get into the membership economy and how to make sure that they really are getting their leadership team prepared for thinking very differently about strategy?
Yeah, so I think the first thing is to get them out talking to customers and really understanding what is the value that they provide. What is the, you know, as Clayton Christian says, what's the job that your product does for them? And that's one piece. Also getting into their shoes and understanding what technologies they expect and see as the new normal. And the other thing is not getting too wrapped up in the technology. Because even though technology is great, it's not great when it's not in service to an actual benefit for the person you're trying to serve, the customer.
So how do we become more curious? How should we look at new businesses? Yeah. What are some questions we should ask?
It's a good question. So becoming more curious is, it's innate. We all are curious. If you get back, if you've been with a four-year-old recently, yes. you know we are born to ask questions.
Yes.
And over time, I think we get embarrassed about it or we think we know too much. So what I'd suggest is, you know, ask questions, look at businesses, think to yourself, why is this business successful? What can I learn from this business? You know, and putting things together, you know, a lot of people have said to me, you know, we want to be the Netflix of our industry, right? And on some level, you can't copy an organization. On the other hand, if you say, what would that look like? So you'd ask the second question. So, okay, great. What would it look like if you're the Netflix of your industry? What would that be? If you Amazoned your competitors, what would that mean? And so sometimes just asking the second question is a great way to really break open the paradigm.
Great. Well, so many wonderful things that you have to share. Go and talk to customers, ask better questions, try to understand which organizations are doing well and why. Be curious about it.